Hello, hello, thanks for tuning in. Today we wanted to show you guys how much power our 400 watt solar panel array is producing in the winter time. This is towards the end of December now, and these are four 100 watt Renogy solar panels. If you haven't seen the unboxing video, click the link above. These are on a solar ground mount, and they are angled for the proper winter angle. So we'll go in and see how much these things will produce over the entire day, and around noon is probably when we're going to get the peak out of to see if these things will produce the same amount of wattage as they're rated for. Now this power generation may not be the same for everybody. In fact, it'll be different for everybody. This is just what this array is producing, and there are a bunch of trees that block the area. So we get scattered sun throughout the day in the winter, and then one good patch here for about an hour, hour and a half, where you're gonna see peak production. And then in the summertime, it picks back up and generates way more power. So we'll look at everything and see how much power we generate. Okay, it's currently 8 o'clock in the morning. We got about 13 volts in the solar panel. 12.6 and nothing going on, so we're gonna see how much power we get today and if the solar panels will produce the same amount they do in the summertime, so stay tuned. Also wanted to add in the record. You see we have nothing produced today, 12:23, just a couple days before Christmas, so we are in the middle of winter, and we'll see what we get. Alright, so we are pulling a load now, about 10 watts from DC side, and about 200 watts on an inverter, just to bring the battery down so we can get the panels to kick off here in the morning. Alright, it's just after 9 a.m., we're bringing in about 4 watts of power. Battery is maintaining about 50%, we're still drawing down a small load, and we're going to see the record for the day so far. Probably nothing, honestly. Let me get this charger out of there. Yeah, we don't have anything on the record for today. Still too early in the morning. So we drew down about 0.024 kilowatts, discharged 2 amp hours. So we'll let it keep going and see what our actual maximum output is for the winter time. Alright, so it's just before 10, we're bringing in about 12 watts, still hanging on around 50% battery, and we still have the same load on, charging a phone and a little 200 watt heater. It is winter time, and there are trees, and the sun is low in the ground, so that's why at 10 o'clock we're still not producing a lot, but the battery is staying right around that 50% point, so it's not charged or discharged per se. Well, let me take that back. It's not fully discharged. It's at the 50% mark, what a lead acid, sealed lead acid should be. So we'll see if that picks back up and brings it into the charge mode. Okay, so again, just before 10, the solar wattage is starting to pick up now. The sun is peering over the trees. So we're bringing in about 1.38 amps to the battery, about a half amp into the MPPT charge controller. And we'll go to the record here. As you can see, we've generated 0.012 kilowatt hours, or about 1 amp hour. So we'll let it continue to produce power and see where we're at. Okay, it's just before 11, and as you can see, we're only bringing in 8 watts. Again, this is winter time. This is a 400 watt array, and there are some trees blocking because the sun is low in the sky. You see there, we generated and used the same amount of kilowatt hours, charged and used the same amount of amp hours, so 3 amp hours so far. We've seen a max of 60 watts, and the system's been on 21 days because this is just going through test phases to make sure everything is good. Why is that not working? There we go. Sorry about all the movement, but we'll come back and we'll check around lunchtime and see what happens. Okay, here we are at the app. And as you can see, we're bringing in 69, almost 70 volts, over 350 watts at 5 amps. The battery's at 12.6, 71%. This is a 100 amp hour sealed lead acid. As you can see, the MPPT charge controller is boosting the 5 amps coming in up top from the solar panel to 27 going into the battery. Now down here, that's my DC load. We have the old faithful Coleman cooler hooked to it. If you want to see that, click the link above. It's a pretty decent DC cooler. So that pulls about 5.5 amps at 68 watts. We also have a 400 watt ceramic heater plugged in, along with a Ryobi battery charger charging batteries. So that's simulating a deep load on this. And as you can see, we're pushing out over 350 watts in the winter time. That is phenomenal for solar panels. That's because we are in the ideal situation with it being angled and facing due south. So we can control the load. Let's see if that does anything, switching that load off. Watch and see if that wattage jumps up on the solar side. And it doesn't. You see the MPP charge controller is regulating everything coming in, and it'll lower the wattage in correspondence to the battery to keep it good. Turn that load back on, and you'll see the wattage up here go right back up. And if you see, we're producing again around 350 watts or so. So, is a 400 watt array capable of producing 400 watts in the winter? Sure, as long as the conditions are met. Outside temperature's pretty cool out. The panels are on a ground mount. They're angled properly. And as you can see, we're getting the best bang for our buck here. And if you come down to the record, so that's today's power. We already generated 0.129 kilowatts, charged 10 amp hours, and we discharged 5. The max wattage was actually 380 at one point. So as you can see, 380 out of 400 watts, that's doing very well. The efficiency is super well on that. So yeah, we'll let it charge up and we'll see what happens. Alright, it's 12:30. I've seen a max wattage of 370, which puts these panels at over 90% efficient in the wintertime, which is great. You see, we're bringing in 26.5 amps to the battery charging, with only 5 amps coming in. We're still pulling a decent load on the DC side. So we have an inverter producing AC and a DC socket pulling directly out. You see there, we've already charged 0.276 kilowatt hours or 23 amp hours. It says the max charge was 352, but it takes a while to refresh. So we'll go back and we'll see that we'll actually be bringing in a little bit more. Like I said, about 371 is what I've seen max today. And this is winter time, almost Christmas. So these things are maintaining over 80%, so between 80 and 90% efficient in the winter time right now, which is phenomenal. And we'll come back and check it in a little while again. Just wanted to add this to the video. We're bringing in about 380 watts. I don't think it's going to do it now. Got some clouds passing probably. So we're still putting in a very decent amount of charge in there in the middle of winter. Let's just read the battery here. So, sealed lead acid. Everything's good there. That's how much we brought in. About 30 amp hours so far. Not bad. It's only been going about an hour or so. Okay, it's about 12 minutes later, and as you can see, the battery is back up at 100%, 99-100. I did turn the heater load down to raise the battery back up, so I will turn it back on so that you can see the load draw on this thing again. And we'll see the battery start to go down and the wattage start to kick up, because this is an MPPT charge controller, so it is watching the battery voltage and amperage. So we'll let it ride out to about 1 o'clock and turn the battery back off and see if we can get it back up to 100. This is a 100 amp hour sealed lead acid battery that we are using to test as well. Okay, so it's just before 1 p.m. The sun is passing behind some trees now, and you can see I turned off all the loads because I want to bring the battery back up to a 100% status charge. So we're going to go ahead and let this thing charge back up. And as you can see, in a 1 hour time span, we did gain about 0.25 kilowatt hours, 0.250 kilowatt hours, so 31 amp hours so far. Not bad for about an hour of sun charge. And you see, it's going behind trees, so it's going to be up and down, but we'll let the battery charge back up to full. Okay, it's been a couple hours, as you can see. Back behind the trees now. Again, this is winter time, so the sun's sitting low. Brought the battery almost back up to 100%. It's 94%. We're still bringing in about 3/4 of an amp. Produced about 0.400 kilowatts. 33 amp hours. We had a max charge power of 380, so in the winter time, and there are some trees in the way, so we may cut the trees a little bit to allow for more sun to come through. But typically in a couple hours in winter time, that's not bad. That's what you can expect. This is not ideal for everybody. Every situation is going to be different, but if you angle the panels right, you can get the most power out of them. Hope this helps. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.